This is the second part of our series on targeting vision applications to FPGA or ASIC hardware. The previous video outlined some high-level considerations for adapting an algorithm for hardware implementation. This video will overview a recommended workflow from a MATLAB algorithm to an FPGA implementation. Algorithm work typically starts in MATLAB, and MATLAB is great at manipulating large data sets such as image matrices, exploring mathematical algorithms, and visualizing data. On the other hand, Simulink is great for adding the implementation detail that you need to describe how your algorithm will work in streaming hardware. You can still include MATLAB code within Simulink, but Simulink lets you express and visualize parallel architectures, it has a built-in sense of timing, and can show you how data types and sizes propagate through calculations, which are all key aspects of creating a good hardware implementation for your algorithm. So our recommended workflow, based on our experience across thousands of customer projects, is use your MATLAB algorithm as a golden reference to verify that your hardware implementation gets the right answers. Move to Simulink to build a hardware implementation for your algorithm. Convert to fixed point in Simulink, where you can visualize the word lengths propagate through the design. Use Simulink's visualization to optimize your hardware implementation before you generate HDL code. And verify that each refinement functions properly. Using the lane detection example, here is the MATLAB algorithm. It's based on the automated driving system toolbox example. The test bench reads in a video file and sends a frame at a time to the algorithm, which returns parabolic lane boundaries. At the same time, it stores the frames to a workspace variable that will be used to drive the hardware implementation. The test bench displays the input video and a version with the lane overlay outputs from the algorithm. It also stores the parabolic equation parameters for each frame here in the structure, which gets used later to check the results of the hardware implementation. Now, I could have pretty easily replicated this test environment in Simulink, but since I've already done this work in MATLAB, I can use that and call Simulink using the sim command, passing data back and forth via workspace variables. Over in Simulink, the input to the hardware model is this video from workspace block, which uses that workspace variable and the sample time parameter. In the model, the first thing that needs to be done is to convert the incoming frames to a stream of pixels. This gateway block is from Vision HDL Toolbox, and with Simulink you can see the changes in the data types, from the 480 by 640 frame to 1 pixel at a time. The difference in colors is showing sample rate differences. The output needs to be sampled every pixel, whereas the input needs to be sampled once every 420,000 pixels, which represents one frame with horizontal and vertical blanking included. In this block, you can specify a preset or custom frame size. It will automatically convert the frame to a stream of pixels at the faster sample rate, and will also add in horizontal and vertical blanking intervals to give time to the processing to catch up. And it generates a control signal bus for managing the stream, with signals to specify the beginning and end of rows and frames, along with a valid signal. Also notice in this diagram the clock signal. There's no clock in the Simulink design, but there is on an FPGA. The default mapping is one unit of Simulink sample time maps to one clock period on the FPGA, which for, say, a 200 MHz frequency would be a 5 nanosecond clock period. Before moving into the hardware implementation details in Simulink, I want to step back and show the rest of the simulation environment. The sample-by-sample results get buffered here to return to the test bench. This isn't generating a video frame out, just lane boundary coordinates. It's likely this buffer gets implemented on the software side in the final product, but I use it here to reduce and condition the data passed back to the test bench. Back in the MATLAB test bench, I just get the lane boundary coordinates from the workspace variable and compare the distance from the center to the lane boundaries to the offset parameter from the reference parabolic equation. For this application, I'm okay with a 20% tolerance due to the fixed point quantization and the algorithm's curve fitting estimates. Now I can just run right from MATLAB, simulating 30 frames in MATLAB, then in Simulink, which takes about 9 minutes on my laptop, so I'll just cut to the results. Every time you add new details to your implementation model, you should verify it, either against the previously verified model or against the golden reference, which is what I did here. If I create a new model, I can just pass that model to the sim command. But it depends on your specific design's characteristics and requirements. Part 3 of this series covers adding hardware implementation details to the design.